Hello! Welcome to this how-to video. My name is Andrea Schumann. I'm a support architect for SAP Cloud ALM. In this video, I will demonstrate how to set up integration and exception monitoring for SAP Fieldglass in SAP Cloud ALM. I will show you how to create an API application key and a web service in SAP Fieldglass, how to create an endpoint in SAP Cloud ALM, and how to activate the monitoring data collection. To create an API application key in SAP Fieldglass, you need a user with Fieldglass Configuration Manager access. You can link this user to your own personal user for temporary access. Please contact the SAP Fieldglass administrator in your organization to obtain such a user. Furthermore, you should request a dedicated user to be used as virtual person in the web service that will be created during the setup. The user should not be a personal user, but rather be created specifically for this purpose. To create the API application key, switch to the Configuration Manager user. Click on your user icon in the upper right corner and click on Linked Accounts. Open the application Create API Application Key. Enter the application name and an application description. Click the Create button. Now you can create a web service for the application. Under Setup Web Service, click the New button. Select the user created for this web service from the drop-down field for Virtual Person Name. Set the status to Enabled. Save the web service. Go back to the API application key list by clicking on the link in the upper left corner. Here you find your API application key as well as the web service. For the setup in SAP Cloud ALM, you will need the API application key from the API application keys table and the virtual person name and the license key from the web services table. This concludes the setup in SAP Fieldglass. Now we get to the setup in SAP Cloud ALM. Log on to your SAP Cloud ALM tenant. Make sure that you have the authorization, integration monitoring, integration architect to be able to perform the necessary setup steps. The first step is to create an endpoint for your SAP Fieldglass tenant in the Landscape Management. You find the Landscape Management app in the group Administration. Open the Landscape Management app. Your SAP Fieldglass tenant should already be available in the Landscape Management, as it is automatically imported from the System Landscape Information Service at SAP. Click on the Name or the Details button for the cloud service. On the tab Endpoints, click the Add button to add a new endpoint. Enter an endpoint name and a description. Select Integration Monitoring as use case for this endpoint. The root URL is automatically copied from the cloud service information in the Landscape Management. Select OAuth to Client Credentials as authentication type. In the field Client ID, enter the virtual person name. In the field Client Secret, enter the license key. The token service URL is the root URL extended by the string shown here. You also find this string in the SAP Cloud ALM for Operations Expert portal under Integration and Exception Monitoring Details, SAP Fieldglass, Setup Steps in SAP Cloud ALM. For the field API Key, enter the API Application Key. You can use the Check Connection button to see if your connection works. Save your endpoint. This concludes the activities in Landscape Management. The last step is to activate the data collection for integration and exception monitoring for the SAP Fieldglass service. You find the Integration and Exception Monitoring app in the group SAP Cloud ALM for Operations. Open Integration and Exception Monitoring. To be able to perform the configuration, the cloud service needs to be in scope for integration and exception monitoring. Open the scope selection. Make sure Display Service contains all. Add your SAP Fieldglass service to the selection. Click the Apply button. Now open the configuration panel using the rack wheel icon in the upper right corner. In the Services tray, you find your SAP Fieldglass service. Activate the data collection by sliding the lever from off to on. Activate the auto refresh for the application if it's not active. You will see the collected Fieldglass messages after a few minutes. This concludes the standard setup for integration and exception monitoring. Thank you for watching this video. You now know how to set up integration and exception monitoring for SAP Fieldglass with SAP Cloud ALM. For further information regarding the technical setup, feel free to consult the SAP Cloud ALM for Operations Expert Portal, which is continuously updated with the latest news. A link to the Expert Portal is provided in the description of this video.